everyone, and welcome to the newest edition of my video blog. For this edition, I have quite a few topics to talk about. First of all, for those of you who have been paying attention to the news, you know that Donald Trump recently used his executive power to pardon Scooter Libby. For those of you who don't know, Scooter Libby was the aide to former Vice President Dick Cheney, who was involved in blowing up the cover of a CIA agent. He was then later, I believe, prosecuted and convicted for lying about what he did. Now, according to what I've been hearing, a lot of people are feeling that Trump's pardoning of Scooter Libby could be a sign to members of his own cabinet not to cooperate with Robert Mueller's Russia investigation, because ultimately he would pardon them just as he has pardoned Scooter Libby. Now, honestly, I see this as great motivation for the Democrats to succeed in taking back control of Congress after the midterms this year. Now, of course, as I previously stated here on my video blog, Republican pollster Frank Luntz has stated that there actually is a good chance that Democrats could take back both the House and the Senate. As I reported previously, Democrats need 23 seats in the House and 2 seats in the Senate to take back control. In other words, overall in Congress, Democrats need 25 seats to retake their majority. If Democrats are successful in doing that, then when the new session of Congress starts in January of 2019, next year, they can proceed with the impeachment of Donald Trump. That, of course, is if the Russia investigation hasn't already removed Trump. Now, something that I've been thinking of, an idea that I've had on my mind, is that should it play out that way, that congressional Democrats go through and impeach Donald Trump, what they should then do afterwards is to approach current Vice President Mike Pence and tell him not to even consider replacing Trump in the Oval Office, because if he did, congressional Democrats would then proceed to impeach Mike Pence for his role in Donald Trump getting into the Oval Office. Another big piece of news that has come out of today is that Donald Trump has ordered the United States Armed Forces to begin missile attacks against Syria. There have been a couple other countries, I forget their names offhand right now, that are joining in with the United States in, you know, attacking Syria. Now, concerning something that I've reported previously here on my video blog, Ace Hardware is one of the companies that initially agreed to pull its advertising from Laura Ingraham's show on Fox News. Well, I've been informed by people on social media that apparently Ace Hardware has decided to do a 180, reverse its stance, and resume advertising on Laura Ingraham's Fox News show. Now, the general opinion that I'm getting of that from a lot of people on social media is that that must mean that Ace Hardware is intent on bringing down its sales. You know, possibly driving people to go to either Lowe's or Home Depot or many of the other home improvement retailers. And as has been reported in the news as of lately, Facebook CEO Mark Zuckerberg was recently called to testify before Congress as far as what's been going on with Facebook, such as their involvement in the 2016 election and getting Donald Trump put in office. Now, there was a senator there by the name of Ted Cruz who brought up claims of Facebook censoring, conservatives or conservative content. Now, I have stated to people on social media, more specifically on Twitter, that if I was able to respond on behalf of Mark Zuckerberg to Senator Ted Cruz's statement, I would say to Senator Cruz, then, why is it that the Facebook clone Tea Party community can be selective or more or less discriminatory in who it allows, to use its platform? So, more or less realistically showing the just complete and utter hypocrisy within the American political right wing. So I think that is about all to talk about for this video blog entry. Now, for those of you who are friends with me on Facebook, you are aware that right before I, in a sense, relaunched my video blog recently, I made the announcement that I would more or less push myself to be doing daily video blog entries. So what that means is that even on the weekend, I will be doing videos for my YouTube channel. So, that having been said, I thank you all for tuning into my video blog and for watching this video. As always, take care of yourselves and each other, and I hope to see you all right back here next time for my next entry. Until then, have a great day, everyone.